I think the big news of the day is the Moderna vaccine going into phase three. Is that right? So we have a ton of questions. Like, what's phase three? How long does that take? What do you know about this, what's it called? Vaccine.
All right, so the Moderna vaccine is one of the first ones that has gotten really going here. This is a phase three, which means they're putting it in a lot of people, 30,000 people in 87 different locations across the U.S., which is great. You have places with a lot of cases and not so many cases. And what they're looking for is still safety, and they're looking for effectiveness. Will it prevent you from getting infected? So they're going to take half these people and give them the vaccine, and half they're not going to get the vaccine. They're going to get what we call a placebo, and then they're going to send them out into the world and say you should still physically distance, you should still wear face masks, and then periodically bring them in and see if they've gotten infected. And then maybe after 6 months, I'm thinking now, what are we in, the end of July? Probably by the end of the year, they're going to say, okay, how did this vaccine do? How many people were infected who got the vaccine compared to how many people were infected who did not? And that will give us the efficacy. And the FDA has said, if it's 50% or better, we're going to license this vaccine. So it's an important milestone here.
Okay. All right. A lot of questions. So you think, so 6 months, how long does that normally take in a phase three trial? Do they speed it up for this?
Yeah, they've sped it up. It would take normally a few years to do this. Enrollment alone, just think, 30,000 people in 87 different places. You have to have at each place doctors and nurses and other people involved in setting up the study. Because, you know, what happens is people apply to be part of it. Then they look at your medical records and see if you fit what they want, you know, the age and the demographics and comorbidities and so forth. And then they have to bring you in and check you out, take some blood, take down your medical history, and then give you the vaccine. It's really a long process. So normally it would take years. We're speeding it up. In fact, the phase two isn't even over yet. Normally the phase two would go on for about a year, but they got the results after a couple of months of the phase two, and they decided we have to go forward because it's an emergency, obviously.
Wow, that's amazing. That's amazing how it's doing that. When they tell people to go out in the world, should they tell them to act normal? Or, I mean, you mentioned you have to physically distance, still wear a face mask and all that.
Yeah.
To get better results, wouldn't you just want to go out and without that stuff?
Yes, of course. But ethically, they cannot tell people, go have a blast, go to bars, go to restaurants, right? Don't wear your face mask. You know, hug people every minute. No, they can't do that. They are ethically unable to do that. So they have to tell people to behave properly. Face masks, physical distancing, stay out of bars and restaurants and so forth. But as with all vaccine trials, you know, when they do an AIDS vaccine trial, they do the same thing. They say you have to be safe. And what they're hoping is that still, despite them telling that, people are going to misbehave a little bit and get infected. And they're depending on that, of course, to do that. But no, ethically, they cannot tell people to let it all hang out.
Wow. That was deep and insightful. I want more of that. Like, subscribe, get more.